In this lesson, we will study about the sleeper and its requirements. So, to get started with, sleepers are nothing but these transverse members which are laid under your rails. These are railed to support the rails at the gauge distance apart. So, this distance is called as what? Gauge distance. To fix them in position, normally we use the sleepers. Okay, so if you see the figure, you can see different types of sleepers made of different materials like concrete, steel and wooden sleepers in the figure, right? We'll study more about the types of sleepers in the next lesson. For now, let us understand the definition of sleeper. Okay, so the members laid transversely under the rails for supporting and fixing them at gauge distance apart are called as what? Are called as sleepers. Right. Now, next, let us study some of the functions of the sleepers. So, what roles the sleeper has to perform when they are laid under the rails? We have to see one by one. So, there are different functions. The first function is to support the rail firmly and evenly. So, the main function of your sleeper is to support your rail. Okay, support the rail. How should the support be? It should be firm and even. Okay, next point is it has to maintain the gauge of the track correctly. Say if some distance of the gauge, suppose broad gauge is given, broad gauge has certain width, right? This has to be maintained properly throughout the length of the rail. Okay, sleeper has to perform this. It cannot be that it will allow the rail to push aside or tilt aside and change the gauge. Basically, it has to maintain the gauge of the track correctly. Okay, so to maintain the gauge of the track correctly. Next, third function is it has to distribute the weight which is coming on the rail over a sufficiently large area of ballast. Say, for example, this is your rail, right? So, under this rail, you will have your sleeper. After this, you will have, under this, you will have your ballast. So, whatever axial load which is coming onto this rail, this axial load need to be evenly spread to your ballast. And the sleeper should help or allow the axial load to be distributed evenly onto the ballast. That is also one of the important function of your sleeper. So, to distribute the weight coming on the rails over a sufficiently large area of the ballast. Next, the fourth thing is it has to provide an elastic medium. Between what? It has to provide an elastic medium between your rails and ballast, so that the ballast and the rails can absorb the vibrations of the rail. Okay, basically it has to act as an elastic medium in order to what? Vibrations of the rail. This is also one of the important functions. Then the fifth function is to provide easy replacement. Whenever you have to replace your rail fastenings without any serious disturbance of the traffic, easy replacement should be possible. That function also your sleeper has to take care. Okay, and in case of the next point is, in case of your electrified sections, what should your sleeper do? Sleeper should permit insulation, or else there are chances that there will be shock occurring into the train, right? So it has to permit insulation to the track, especially in the area of electrified sections, right? Next is it has to maintain the alignment of the track without much changes. It has to maintain the proper alignment of the track so that the movement of trains over your track will be very smooth and undisturbed. So these are some of the functions of the sleepers. Let's see what are the requirements of a good sleeper. So if you want to call a sleeper which you use to be ideal, it has to follow certain things. Only then you can call that it is a good sleeper or an economical sleeper or an ideal sleeper. So there are many points. Let's list out one by one. The first one is it should be economical. I'll just write down the bullets and explain you the entire concept. Right. The sleeper should be what? Economical in their initial as well as the maintenance cost. So even in initial cost, it should be economical, as well as in the maintenance cost, it should be economical. It should not be too expensive. Right. That is the first requirement of a good sleeper. Then it should have long life. Whatever life you have designed it for, it should serve that particular life. Then it should maintain the correct age. So the sleeper should be in such a way that it maintains the correct gauge of the track. Then the fourth requirement is what? The sleeper should be such that the fittings which are there connected to the rails and the sleepers, they should be able to easily remove that, replace that, lift that and pack that whenever required. So removal, replacement, lifting and packing of fittings or fixtures, what should be easy. That is one of the requirements. Then moving on further, fifth requirement is it should have sufficient weight for their stability. That is what, it should not be too heavy nor it should be too light. So the weight should be sufficient, or what you can call it as moderate. The weight of the sleeper should be sufficient or moderate. It should not be too heavy or too light. In both these cases, there will be problems faced by your sleeper. Okay. Then sixth requirement is it should be of such a design that the gauge alignment of track and levels of rails can be easily adjusted and maintained. Suppose, alignment of the track will change or the level of the rails will change. The sleeper should allow us to do adjustments for the level alignment of the track as well as for the leveling of the rails. Okay. Alignment of track or levels of rails should be easily what? Adjusted and also maintained. That is one of the requirements. Then the seventh requirement is what? They should provide sufficient bearing area below the rail seat over the ballast. So below the rail and over the ballast, there should be what? Sufficient bearing area. Why this should be allowed? Because it has to properly transfer the load onto your ballast. So provision of sufficient bearing area is one of the important criteria which the sleepers has to perform. Okay. Next is they should be in such a design so that they facilitate easy removal and replacement of ballast. We already saw for fixtures and fasteners also, there should be easy replacement and removal. Same with the ballast. Okay. So your sleeper should be in such a way that your removal or replacement of ballast can be easy. Okay. In case of ballast. Next. They should be in such a design that they are not damaged during packing and boxing of ballast. So the sleeper should be in such a way that whenever you are doing some packing or boxing of ballast, they should not affect the sleepers. Right. So during packing and boxing of the ballast, the sleepers should not be affected. Their design should be in such a way. Okay. Then they should be quite durable. Okay. So the sleepers should be what? Durable. That is, they should offer sufficient resistance to whatever weathering action they are exposed to. They have to have sufficient resistance towards that particular weathering action. Next is they should have track circuiting. This is one important point. Track circuiting. So the sleeper should have track circuiting. What is the meaning of track circuiting? The process of connecting track length by a electric circuit. So if there is a railway track like this, and if we connect this with the electric circuits for case of your trains which are moving with the help of electricity, so it should provide what? Proper provision. Okay, or insulation. That is also one of the important criteria. And it should have resistance towards your impact or vibrations of heavy wheels of high speed train. So resistance what? Resistance to impact vibrations of trains due to heavy wheel load or high speed of train. Okay, so this is also one of the requirements. Then next requirement is it should have sufficiently high, the type of sleeper what we use should have sufficiently high scrape value. So once it is discarded, it has to have some scrape value. Okay, so along with all this, it also has to be designed in such a way that these sleepers should not get pushed out of their position in any direction under even the maximum of the maximum train load or moving load which is coming onto that. So these are some of the ideal requirements. These are some of the requirements of an ideal sleeper. So hope you understood the concepts clearly. In the next lesson, we'll study about the types of sleepers. Thank you.